the City of New York, the Puffin Activist Gallery, Labor Arts, the Triangle Shirtwaist Factory Fire, the Rubin Foundation, and all of us here, I want to say congratulations to the Lemlich recipients. Some of you have heard me say this for 5 years now, that this is my favorite night of the year because we're lucky enough to hear these amazing women who've been fighting and continue to fight, which is what I hope we're all going to do when we leave here.
We are honored to introduce Gloria Sukenik. She has been an important activist in women's rights and housing struggles since the 1950s. In the 50s, there were very few women lawyers, doctors, scientists, and professors. Now look at today. All of this was unheard of back then.
Gloria didn't stop there. She and fellow activists would go to rich suburban neighborhoods where the landlords lived and demonstrate right outside their dorm. That's the kind of woman Gloria is. She's a woman of action.
I want to tell you, there's nothing more satisfying than being an activist. There's nothing more satisfying than 20 years later having somebody come up to you on the street and say, I remember when you helped me with my housing when I lived on so-and-so street, and you helped me fight my landlord, and you helped me keep my apartment. There's nothing, nothing really, that beats that feeling that people 20 years later will recognize that you've done something of worth. I guess I'm speaking mostly to these two young ladies. You're gonna love it.
She is the consummate activist and scholar. She's an economist, among other things. She knows her stuff. And I want to say to you that over 60 years, I am proud to say she is smart, charming, compassionate, a visionary, and my very good friend, Win Armstrong.
There's protest, there's pressure, there are proposals, there's policy and policy analysis, and then you go to the operations, and then you go to the job descriptions, because if it doesn't get into the job descriptions, the policy, the operations won't happen and the policy won't get done. And then we often have to go back because some of this is or isn't working. Many of us have started with a situation that we did or did not like, or wanted to improve or keep. Realized that the situation is based on a system, and in many ways that system may not be working. We've had to go to concepts and figure it out, do our analysis, regroup our roles. Again, I just wanted to reflect with you because I think many of you, as I say, have been very involved as we have, and in a sense, it takes one to know one.
Julie is a huge believer in giving back to the community. And I think one of Julie's strengths is to bring diverse groups of people together. She's very charming, as you'll soon see. And she has opened up her home to numerous organizations. She's given out the unofficial address of so many different groups and committees. And we just really thank you for your generosity.
I was so frightened of speaking publicly, of trying to get the right words out, that I went to the kitchen. And for decades, I made tea and created potlucks and made sure that the food was out there. For decades, I did. And what happened in those decades is that people kind of expected me to show up, you know, because I'm going to do the food. And then I got to be a decider of what the program was going to be, and I still didn't have to speak, which I thought was really good. So I'm like a puppet master, you know? So, and this whole potluck thing brings people together, and you give everyone an assignment to do, and they have a sense of home and a sense of belonging with this food thing. So I've never been able to stand up and talk about policy. I've never been able to recommend what we should do or how we should go out in the street and do that stuff. I am somebody who just wants to give you a sense of community and a sense of home together.
Welcome up here. Put your hands together for the sister, this hermana, the si se puede attitude, Sylvia Gutierrez Grant.
And then I went to work for 1199, which was actively organizing and assisting workers to have a union. There I used my energies and social consciousness to learn what it meant to fight for equal rights, especially for women. And to think that that struggle still continues today. We stand together here today commemorating women who spearheaded a revolution and galvanized workers into unions. We still have a lot of work to do. Will we do it?
Yes.
Can we do it? Yeah. Yes, we can. Si se puede. You are the union.
Hi, my name is Michael Miller, and I am the great-grandson of Clara Lemlich. Although I never had the opportunity to meet my great-grandmother, her values and her strong-willed personality are mirrored throughout all the award winners today. Now, I want to talk about the legacy that Clara has left on my family specifically. Most importantly, her willingness to stand up for herself and in turn help others in the face of adversity.
I think the labor movement needs a renaissance.
Many people in this room have organized and organized and organized. And you know, her, I always say her spirit, and the spirit of people in this room, current and people we remember. We are alive and we're kicking.
The important thing is that the word social activism has now become a byword throughout the United States.
Whether sitting down at the Times Square recruiting station with Granny Peace Brigade during the Iraq War, or in Vieques, or in New York for Vieques, to protest the naval base, the U.S. naval base in Puerto Rico, or going to Fort Benning to close the School of the Americas, better known as the School of the Assassins, or more recently, going to Occupy Wall Street every day. Lillian Lifflander's life is indeed one to be celebrated.
Anne interacts with engineers, scientists, state representatives from the New York State DEC, city reps from NYC DEP, US EPA, NYSP, I don't know all of these acronyms, my God, for the purpose of advocating for the residents for cleaner air, water, better parks, recreation, and expanded opportunities for youth and to improve the public health.
I accept this award as a tribute to the fight to preserve and strengthen our country's effort to champion the causes of humanity. On behalf of my people, community, vision, neighbors, near and far, and it has been all of that.
Environment and in society at large. We need to
do away with the idea that public space is a male domain. And like you all, I'm inspired by them, and by Clara Lemlich, and by the women who are honored here. Let us recall that movements are often born when somebody channels the courage to stand up and declare, I want to say a few words. I commend each of you for courageously seizing that moment in your own lives, in tirelessly speaking the truth and advocating for your communities. You have also empowered your sisters in the next generation to